How does one even begin to tell the story of their hero? Do they start by saying where they were at in that point in time of their life? I don't know, but I feel it is as good a place as any to start. I was aimlessly wandering. That is where I was at, wondering what I was doing, where I was going, and how was I to get there. Then a one-eyed, 5-pound little dog came across my Facebook feed, and everything changed. Harley Freight Train Taylor, a little one-eyed 5-pound dog, came across my Facebook feed late one evening, and when I saw his picture, I thought to myself, oh my God, what happened to this little guy? So I went to his page and I spent the rest of the evening reading his story. I read how he had lived in a cage and how his one and only job was to produce puppies. His sole purpose of existence was to make puppies and then to make more puppies. While reading Harley's page that evening, I learned about an industry that I wasn't aware of, puppy mills, and what an eye-opening learning experience that was. This tiny little dog had spent the first 10 years of his life in a puppy mill, and he had a job to do. That job was to produce puppies for profit. That was his only chore in life. He wasn't to be loved. He wasn't to receive medical care. His little painful feet didn't matter, so no, it wasn't important to provide a soft cushion on the floor of his wire cage. It wasn't important to remove him from his cage to power wash it either. I learned that in puppy mills, it is acceptable to power wash the dog's cage without removing the animal or protecting its eyes from being blown out. After all, eyes aren't needed to produce puppies. As I continued to read Harley's page, every day I learned so much about these horrible places called puppy mills. I learned that Harley was considered livestock by the USDA, and that outraged me. Dogs are not livestock. They are family pets and members. The more I read, the more something inside me was awakened. I was discovering a passion and a purpose to help spread the word of the horrors of puppy mills. I couldn't get enough of Harley and his voice of knowledge. I learned that when the puppy mills no longer considered Harley capable of producing puppies, they tossed him in a bucket while he was still alive. Can you imagine being tossed away like yesterday's garbage without a second thought? However, with luck on Harley's side this time, he was pulled and rescued not only from the bucket, but from the puppy mill life. On the brink of death, this dog found his strength and was determined to find his voice. Harley was a mess with a boatload of health issues. He wasn't expected to live 3 months, but this didn't discourage his adoptive parents, Rudy and Dan Taylor. They just wanted to give this little battered soul the best 3 months of his life and for him to spend his last days knowing he was worth loving. But Harley had other ideals. Harley thrived under the care of the Taylors, and Harley found his voice through his mom, Rudy. Harley knew he did have a purpose, and he did still have a job to do, and he would do this with his now parents. Harley was a small dog with a big dream, and that is to shut down puppy mills. Harley knew he had found his way to the right home where his medical issues would be looked after, where he was loved, and most of all, he was safe. He knew he was finally free to carry out his real purpose in life, and it was just beginning. Harley went on to become a spokesdog against puppy mills. He even campaigned as Harley to the rescue with the help of his now best buddy, Teddy, another puppy mill survivor, to raise money to go on mill dog rescues. Harley wasn't slowing down any. His mission took him all the way to becoming the American Hero Dog in 2015. Harley knew he was to save as many dogs as he could from the horrors of puppy mills. But Harley also knew he had another job, and that was to educate as many humans as he could. With all the horrors this little soul had been through, one would have thought he would have a total distrust and dislike for humans, but that wasn't so. Harley loved them. He gave of himself at his meet and greets. He loved his fans, and he connected with them. I got the pleasure of meeting Harley August 28, 2015. It was one of the happiest days of my life. As I was there meeting him with other puppy mill survivors, I learned what precious little souls these forgotten, battered souls are, how loving and forgiving they are, and through Harley, one could see that all they wanted is to be rescued into a loving home, and they would give back 10 times fold. Harley was not just a hero to dogs, he was also a people's hero. Harley brought out the good in people. He showed them that everyone matters, and with love, trust, and hope, all lives could and would improve. Through his page, he let everyone know no one is alone. He was there for them too. Harley helped me to find my passion and my deep love for animals. He helped me to find my purpose to fight for all their rights. Harley helped me to become a better, more forgiving person. I find myself wanting to be like Harley. He was my hero. A one-eyed, 5-pound little male dog became this woman's hero. One of the most important things Harley taught me is to never give up. Giving up is not an option. So I say to anyone, if you ever feel like giving up, don't. Instead, look up and repeat after me, WWHD, what would Harley do? Harley passed away in March of 2016, but his spirit lives on through his parents and his fans. His dream is still being carried on, and I have no doubt that Harley is guiding us all along the way.